بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا ومولانا محمد الصادق الأمين المبعوث رحمة للعالمين، وعلى آله الطاهرين الطيبين، وعلى أصحابه أجمعين، وعلى أزواجه أمهات المؤمنين، وعلى ذريته إلى يوم الدين. سبحانك اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا اللهم علما وعملا وتقبلا، آمين يا رب العالمين. من إسناد المتصل إلى الإمام أبو بكر ابن أبي الدنيا وكتابه كتاب المحتضرين والمحتضرين باب تعزية النفس أو تعزية النفس عند الاحتضار بالصبر والاحتساب. So Assalamu alaikum and welcome to this next lesson in the book of the dying by Ibn Abi Dunya, a great hafiz or hadith master. And we have reached the chapter on strengthening the soul, or strengthening oneself. Ta'ziya is known as condolences in modern Arabic, but really it comes from azza and ta'azzaza. And so, which means strong, Al-Aziz is the mighty, the almighty as a divine name. And so we should really remember that it is not a Western type of condole and suffer with you with compassion. No, it is much more than that. Just as sabr is much more than patience, which is so passive in the act of suffering and endurance. Rather, there is fortitude in sabr. And so, again, there is fortitude in ta'ziya as well. You see, literally speaking, so that's why strengthening, ta'ziya is to offer a strengthening way, strengthening gesture to the one being visited for the loss of a dear one. And also to strengthen oneself at the time of death and dying through fortitude, through sabr, wal-ihtisab, and the expectation of rewards and the trust in Allah's reward. وَبِهِ إِلَيْهِ عَنْ أَبِي مُسْلِمٍ أنه دخل على أبي الدرداء رضي الله تعالى عنه وأرضاه في اليوم الذي قبض فيه. So Abu Darda, the great Sahabi who ended up in Syro-Palestine in Sham, teaching Quran, and his grave is there. He visited it, and his wife and his students, and he would teach Quran to large droves of students in the Umayyad Mosque. And elsewhere as well. And so this Abu Muslim, and this must be Abu Muslim al-Khawlani. Yes, a great wali. They tried, one tyrant in his time tried to burn him, and he couldn't. Finally released him because he could not harm him. And Abu Muslim al-Khawlani was called by Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu the Ibrahim of the Ummah, because of this karama that Allah gave him. And so he entered to see Abu Darda on the day that Abu Darda died. So that was before Abu Darda's death. وَكَانَ عِنْدَهُمْ فِي dot, dot, dot. And the editor thinks that this blank is the word al-izz. فِي الْعِزِّكَ أَنفُسِهِمْ. And they held him dear, just as dear as they held their own souls in their midst, Abu Darda. Or it refers to Abu Muslim himself. But more probably Abu Darda. So Abu Muslim started to make takbir. فَجَعَلَ أَبُو مُسْلِمٍ يُكَبِّرُ. To say Allahu Akbar, Allah is greatest. فَقَالَ أَبُو الدَّرْدَى أَجَلْ. So Abu Darda said yes. هَكَذَا فَقُولُ. This is exactly what you should be saying. فإن الله إذا قضى قضاء أحب أن يرضى. Because when Allah passes a decree of His, a decision of His, He loves for that to be well accepted and embraced, for people to have rida of it. So more than just acceptance, but acceptance with good pleasure on the part of the recipients of that decree, that destiny that Allah ordains. MashaAllah. So we say MashaAllah who can. MashaAllah who can. And Allahu Akbar, any of those zikr, Alhamdulillah, Tabarakallah, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, and so forth. Mention of Allah, this is what he loved. And so Abu Darda approved. وبه إليه عن إسماعيل بن عباد الله أنه قال حدثتني أم الدرداء قالت his wife أم الدرداء and her name was هجيمة بنت حيي الأوصابية. So she came from a sub-tribe of Himyar, Yemen. And that's what the Wassab were. Now, and she was a jurist, a faqiha, well-learned, and she narrated from many sahaba, and she was also extremely worshipful. She narrates, أغمي على أبي الدرداء وبلال ابنه عنده فقال اخرج عني. Abu Darda fainted and Bilal his son was at his side, and Abu Darda told him leave me. ثم قال, after that when he regained consciousness, he said, من يعمل لمثل مضجعي هذا, who is working toward this type of situation where I am right now? And madja really means the place where I'm lying down. Who is working for this deathbed where I find myself? من يعمل لمثل ساعتي هذه, who is working to prepare for this moment of mine that I find myself in? Finds himself quite alone. And we've seen this in many of those reports where the caretakers and the relatives and visitors are in one valley and the dying person is in another valley there, like already completely apart, in worlds apart. And so he's groping for a connection other than the spiritual one, where, but among those that wish to communicate with him, he wishes to communicate back, she, but there is no way to connect. So that's born out of this. You have these such statements, and they are very didactic, of course, in nature, but also reflexive of their own preparation. So I have prepared. Are you preparing? You should be preparing, because look, it has overtaken me. Now it will overtake you. So he's saying, I have prepared. Who has prepared? And then he recites, وَنُقَلِّبُ أَفْئِدَتَهُمْ وَأَبْصَارَهُمْ, and we turn over their hearts and their eyesights, the hearts and the eyesights of the dying. كما لم يؤمنوا به أول مرة, as if it was the first time that they were believing in it, or they did not believe in it in the beginning. ونذرهم في طغيانهم يعمهون, and we leave them blind and groping blindly in their tyranny. This is about the unbelievers, from Surah Al-An'am. ثم يغمى عليه, and then he would faint again. ثم يفيق فيقولها, and then he would wake up and say it again. حتى قبض, and so until his soul was taken back. وعن عمرو بن قيس أن معاذ بن جبل لما حضره الموت قال: انظروا أصبحنا. معاذ, like Abu Darda, also was a teacher of Quran, but for the people of Yemen, and fiqh, and he was a judge for them. And he said on the deathbed, check, is it morning yet? Is it subuh yet? قال فقيل لم نصبح. Not yet, they said. حتى أتي فقيل له قد أصبحت. Or قد أصبحت. It says أصبحت here, but if it was said to him, then more probably it is قد أصبحت. Now it's morning, he was told. And then he said قال, and he passed the night. Now it's in the daytime, he wanted to know. And he said, أعوذ بالله من ليلة صباحها إلى النار. I seek refuge in Allah from a night whose morning means hellfire, or whose morning is ending up in hellfire. مرحبا بالموت, welcome death. مرحبا زائر مغب حبيب, welcome a visitor who does not come often to one person. Beloved, جاء على فاقة, who has come finding me in a state of deprivation, poverty, and I have nothing to offer. Subhanallah. So, and you'll see in several of these reports now coming up. See, this section is very special, not like the one before. These are not ordinary people. The ones before were ordinary rulers. They were big personalities, but these are the awliya of the Sahaba, the friends of Allah, and so they have certain states, and they're very expressive, and they will call themselves, you know, like we'll see a report coming up, this little soul of mine. You don't even say nafsi, you say nufaysa, a small soul, a small nothing of a soul. Nufaysa, they use a diminutive for themselves. So this is a diminutive way of saying ala faqa, in a state of poverty you will find me. And he's addressing death in dear terms. Who can do that? Okay? Compare this to the one saying uffin laki, to the shroud, yani saying I hate you, to his own shroud. But no, this one is not saying that at all. Allahumma innaka ta'lamu أني كنت أخافك. And he addresses Allah and saying, oh Allah, you do know that I feared you. I held you in awe. فأنا اليوم أرجوك. And I today have high hopes in you. إني لم أكن أحب الدنيا وطول البقاء فيها. I did not love this world and to stay long in it, لكري الأنهار, for the sake of digging rivers, ولا لغرس الشجر, nor for planting trees. So this is referring to agriculture, and it is a metaphor for wealth, right? So I did not consider that I was born and lived in this life for the accumulation of wealth, for building up this earth, this world, this transient world. But rather, ولكن لضمأ الهواجر. But rather for the thirst of noon days. Think and see what this is referring to. The thirst of noonday, to find oneself thirsty time and again in the noon time. What is this a metaphor for, you think? وَمُكَابَدَةِ السَّاعَاتِ, and struggling with my whole liver, yani with everything, or every effort of mine, with the seat of love, which is the liver. struggling with the hours of my life. So this is referring to fasting and praying. Praying and fasting, fasting and praying. Worship. وَمُزَاحَمَةِ الْعُلَمَاءِ, and crowding together with the learned people of the religion. بِالرُّكَبِ, knee against knee, up to them, not being shy or not being distant or indifferent or feeling not in need. That such a person who spent time with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam 5, 10, 20 years, and then the next generation comes and they think that we are in no need to sit with them. The same thing with every generation also, those who spent days and decades of accumulating with different jewels and gems of the ummah, of the ulama, and taking what they had, some of what they held in their hearts and minds, and accumulating it and learning it, memorizing it, studying it, trying to understand it, and trying to put it in practice. And then they find themselves amidst people who are completely not in need of that, indifferent to that. They have another source of wealth that they're looking for, and it is a dunya wealth rather. عند حلق الذكر, in the circles of ذكر. نعم. وبه إليه عن الحارث بن عميرة الزبيدي قال إني لجالس عند معاذ بن جبل وهو يموت. I was sitting, and with the lam التوكيد or lam of قسم, as if saying, just like we are sitting, just like you and me now. That's how I was sitting with Mu'adh ibn Jabal as he was dying. He's retelling this account. وَهُوَ يُغْمَ عَلَيْهِ مَرَّةً وَيُفِيقُ مَرَّةً, and he would faint, wake up, faint, wake up. فَسَمِعْتُهُ يَقُولُ عِنْدَ إِفَاقَتِهِ, and I heard him say, meaning sotto voce, not out loud, as if to himself, but he caught it, and so he's relating it. As he was waking up one time, أخنق خنقك فوعزتك إني لأحبك, go ahead and kill me, I swear I do love you. Speaking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the angel of death. So this love and fear at the same time, or submission, but at the same time, this embrace of the state, complete acceptance, not just acceptance and resignation, but a state of complete rida and shukr for it, which is higher yet than just acceptance and submission. Now, and you'll see, it will be mentioned verbatim, complete submission is needed, not just يعني تسليمية. It will come up, inshallah, the mouth of Al-Hasan al-Basri رضي الله عنه. عن أسد بن وداعة قال لما مرض حذيفة, مرضه الذي مات فيه, when حذيفة got sick in his final sickness, when he died, قيل له ما تشتهي, he was asked, what would you like? And usually when we say that, ما تشتهي is sense of taste or food, drink, something like that, and anything else also by extension. And the sick person also in Arabic and traditional medicine, let them eat from what they crave. So what do you crave? See, so it makes them feel better. And you want the person in such a state, a dying state, to feel better. But that's, he's already elsewhere. He says, قال أشتهي الجنة, I crave paradise. قالوا فما تشتكي, so where, what pain do you feel? They want him to feel better. They want to find some way to to help him. قال الذنوب, sins. يعني what ails you? He answers sins. But they cannot help him with that. They cannot help him with what he craves, which is paradise either. قالوا أفلا ندعو لك الطبيب. They go back to their habit. They say, shall we not call the physician for you? قال الطبيب أمرضني. Said the physician is the one who put me in such a sick state. So he means by the physician Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said they are speaking of the created ways and means, and he is speaking of the creator of the ways and means. يعني the causator of the causes. لقد عشت فيكم على خلال ثلاث. Now he is teaching them and admonishing them. I have lived among you, he says, according to three traits or three attributes or three principles, you might say. And the singular is khilla of khilal here. للفقر فيكم أحب إلي من الغنى. I swear that poverty among you is dearer to me than wealth. Who can say that today? They will laugh him out of court because their sense of the certainty of the importance and goodness of wealth and necessity of it is beyond 100%. It is beyond more palpable than any religion among our contemporaries, the people of Ahlul Dunya. And yet he is saying, no, I prefer more. This is straight from the prophetic directives, straight from hadith. And he's repeating it. He was the secret keeper of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the keeper of secrets of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So, and he continues, وَلَضَّعَتُ فِيكُمْ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِنَ الشَّرَفِ. And he says, and I swear that lowliness among you is more beloved and dearer to me for you than nobility, than honor, than titles. Again, same thing, same remarks as before. So he's speaking the language of paradise to the people of paradise, to Ahl of Akhirah, and he's using prophetic language. وَإِنَّ مَنْ حمدني منكم ولامني في الحق سواء. And whoever of you blames me or praises me for the sake of truth is one and the same to me. Is does not upset me or please me in the least. Is one and the same. No. ثم قال أصبحنا أصبحنا. Then he said, is it morning yet? Is it morning yet? SubhanAllah, why? Why this desire to know if it's morning on the part of the dying? I don't know yet. Maybe you can have some clinical observations about it and solve this issue. قالوا نعم. He said, yes. قال اللهم. See, each time has its worship, and each moment has its tajallis, manifestations. And he's making this dua similar to the one before, from Mu'az or Abu Darda. O Allah, إني أعوذ بك من صباح النار. I seek refuge in you from morning of hellfire. Subhanallah. So in the timing of Akhirah now, because Akhirah is either paradise or hellfire. There is no more 100,000,001 possibilities of what the day has to offer. It's either paradise or hellfire. It's a different reality. And it is also Quranic, yani Sa'a Sabahul Mundareen. Or see, it is like when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent punishment over certain people, and the morning for them was the time of their destruction, the time that they were erased from the face of the earth. They did not expect it. They thought it was going to be another morning like any other, of getting up and feeding the cattle and the chicken and eating and being happy and seeing those that they loved and all the else, no? And then also when Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam entered Khaybar, again he repeated that. They were not expecting that they would be conquered, would wake up and to be subdued by an invading force. See, so this is, there is a lesson in that. So to prepare for the moment, to be a son and daughter of the time in which we live in, which we mentioned that, we speak of so-called environmental awareness and being aware of the times, how they are changing, to adapt. But what about the time of Akhirah, which is ineluctable and coming at any moment? Not when we are precisely over the age of 90 or generally or anything like that, no. So he says, Habibun ja'a ala faqa. A beloved one has come and we are in a state of poverty. He's mentioning the angel of death. La aflaha man nadima. May the one who regrets, may them not be successful. Yani, who regrets what? That, ya laytani qaddamtu li hayati. I wish I had prepared for that moment. I was too busy with digging rivers and planting trees, although it is an excellent endeavor and a good thing that we are. Prophet ﷺ said, even if the day of resurrection is rising and you have a plant in your hand, plant it. If you have a shoot in your hand, plant it. But to be obsessed with that and overwhelmed with it, no. And that's paganism. Even if one is claiming to be a believer, they will be saying, no, I find that I thought that I was going to retire and then be a good person, or to be more worshipful, or. So they regret, and this is nadama, is like hasra, regret, remorse, and saying, well, you know, I don't have glad tidings for those. This again from someone who is saying, I have prepared myself. Are you preparing yourself? This is what this expression is meant to convey. وبه لي عن الحسن, this is الحسن البصري, قال حذيفة في مرضه, حذيفة said in his last illness, حبيب جاء على فاقة, a beloved one has come and found us in a state of poverty, لا أفلح من ندم, the same two expressions we just read, السر بعدي ما أعلم. The secret after me, I do not know of. But then the next sentence, he's mentioning what's going to happen after. الحمد لله الذي سبق بي الفتنة قادتها وعلوجها. May Allah be praised who has taken me before the time of the great fitna, the great dissension. Because he died before the fight between Sayyidina Ali and Sayyidina Muawiyah. So he was happy about that. And that fight, the Prophet ﷺ had told him about it. And he said, more than that, I don't know. That's what he had just said before means. And its leaders and its rude and coarse men. And he's happy that he's dying before the great strife, its leaders, and its disgusting, you know, coarse people. Because they are people who did not know, you know, respect from day one. طيب وبه إليه عن رقبة ابن مسقلة أنه قال لما احتضر الحسن بن علي رضي الله تعالى عنهما, when الحسن the son of سيدنا علي was on his deathbed, قال أخرجوا فراشي إلى صحن الدار, bring out my bed to the court inside the house, the courtyards of the house, صحن الدار. And it's an open air courtyard. It's those old style Arabic houses. We used to live in such a design in Damascus, the house of Mawlana Sheikh Nazir Qudus Allah Sirruhu. قال فرفع رأسه إلى السماء ثم قال, and he raised up his head towards the sky and said, اللهم إني احتسبت نفسي عندك. Allah, I entrust my soul to you and I want you to take care of it. فإنها أعز الأنفس علي, or truly it is the dearest of all souls to me. So, because one is responsible for that, ultimately nothing else, you must take care of that first and foremost. Even in the relationship to all other souls is of import to that very soul. It will either destroy it or build it up, contribute to it. And many will say the same things, the same thing, that this soul is the dearest thing to me, O Allah, I'm giving it to you. Take care of it. عن عمر بن إسحاق قال دخلت أنا ورجل من قريش على الحسن بن علي فقام. I went in with a Qurayshi man to see الحسن بن علي and he got up فدخل المخرج ثم خرج فقال, and he went into the latrine and came out again and said, لقد لفظت طائفة من كبدي أقلبها بهذا العود. I just spat out a piece of my liver and I could just turn it over with this twig, this stick that I'm holding. ولقد سقيت السم مرارا. I have been given poison to drink many times. وما سقيته مرة أشد من هذه. And I never have been given something harsher or more brutal or more nauseous than this time. So he died of poisoning. قال وجعل يقول لذلك الرجل سلني قبل أن لا تسألني. He said to that Qurayshi man who had come in to see him, ask me before you are unable to ask me anymore. قال ما أسألك شيئا يعافيك الله. I'm not going to ask you anything. Allah give you health. قال فخرجنا من عندي. We went out, left him. ثم عدنا إليه من غد وقد أخذ في السوق. And we came back to him the next day and he was already now in the throes of death. السوق is the, يعني, the last breaths. And the death rattle or the last breath, that's the niza or the naza, not before. فجاء حسين حتى قعد عند رأسه فقال. So now سيدنا الحسين رضي الله عنه, the younger brother of سيدنا الحسن, and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said these two, they are the flower of the youth of paradise. We promised them paradise. And he said, my little brother, although he was the little one, but my dear brother, my beloved brother, من صاحبك? Who's that one? Who's your killer? So, sahib is companion, but he means by that, who's that one who's responsible for poisoning you? قال تريد قتله, you want to kill him? قال نعم, he said yes. قال لئن كان صاحبي الذي أظن, if it were the one that I think, لله أشد له نقمة, Allah will punish him harsh, more harshly than you. وإن لم يكن به, and if not, ما أحب أن يقتل بريء, and I do not like that he be killed and when he's innocent. So you see, Al-Hasan was not sure who was his killer. He had his suspicion, but he was not sure. رضي الله تعالى. وبيلا عن أبي السفر قال لما حضر خالد بن الوليد الموت وحوله الناس, when خالد بن الوليد the great general رضي الله عنه among the Sahaba, and he died in Hims, and his sentence is known when he died, he was saying, it's not in this book, but Al-Khalid ibn al-Walid was a great general, and when he died, he was dying in his deathbed, he was saying, I don't have one part of my body except there is the mark of a sword, a blow, or an arrowhead, or a spear wound, and here I am, dying of old age in my bed. And may Allah be praised. And so now he is dying and is surrounded by people. قال رجل ممن حوله والله إنه لا يسوق. And a man said from among the onlookers, I swear by Allah, he's in the last breaths, he's in the throes. سمعنا خالد, خالد heard us, فقال رجل, فاستعن الله. So when they noticed that خالد heard them say that, a man said to him, so ask Allah for help. وعن أبي إسحاق قال قال أبو سفيان ابن الحارث, this is the cousin of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, ابن الحارث ابن عبد المطلب. So his father الحارث was a son of عبد المطلب, just like Abdullah the father of the Prophet was a son of عبد المطلب, and Hamza and Al-Abbas and Abu Lahab, all these were brothers. So he's the Prophet's first cousin, he was also his milk brother. Abu Sufyan ibn al-Harith ibn Abd al-Muttalib, he embraced Islam after the conquest of Mecca and fought on the side of the Prophet ﷺ at Hunayn very hard. And he was of those few who stood their ground around the Prophet ﷺ at the Battle of Hunayn. And when he was dying, لما حضره الموت قال لأهله لا تبكوا علي, do not weep over me. فما تنطفت بخطيئة منذ أسلمت. I did not smear myself or soil myself with a sin ever since I entered Islam. So don't weep over me. Inshallah. See the state of those people when they are dying, strong faith and saying, I feared you, O my Lord, and now I have the highest hope that you will forgive me. وبه إليه قال حدثني عيينة ابن عبد الرحمن قال حدثني أبي أن أبا بكرة, this is Abu Bakr al-Thaqafi, one of the great companions of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, لما اشتكى عرض عليه بنوه أن يأتوه بطبيب. When he was ailing in his last illness, his sons wanted to bring a physician to see him. فأبى, he refused. فلما ثقل وعرف الموت من نفسه وعرفوه منه قال أين طبيبكم ليردها إن كانت صادقة. So when he worsened, his state worsened, and he realized that he would not survive, and they realized as well, he said at that time, where is your position? Let him bring it back if he can. Bring what back? His soul. His soul is leaving him. He's saying, let him bring it back if he can. If he is truthful. قال وما يغني الآن. They said, what can he possibly do now? قال ولا قبله. And before also, he said. So he was saying, and before also. Just like the previous stories where we saw that the dying person is telling them, don't be ignorant. Allah takes whoever he wants, whether powerful or poor, whether also healthy or not. So it's in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and a few seconds of years will not make a difference. I mean, it's there already, subhanallah. قال فجاءت ابنته أمة الله, his daughter أمة الله came. فلما رأت ما به بكت فقال إي بنية لا تبكي. She wept when she saw his state, and he told her, do not, my little daughter, do not weep. قالت يا أبتا فإن لم أبكي عليك فعلى من أبكي. If I do not weep over you, my father, then over whom should I? قال لا تبكي, do not weep. فوالذي نفسي بيده, I swear by the one in whose hand is my soul. ما في الأرض نفس أحب إلي أن تكون خرجت من نفسي هذه. There is no soul on earth that is more, would be more beloved to me that it's coming out more than my own soul. Meaning, I'm happy to be dying. Don't you, aren't you happy that I'm happy? Can't you be happy with me? ولا نفس هذا الذباب الطائر. Not even the soul of that fly that you see flying. And if I could have that fly die instead of me, no, I would not rather. I would rather die myself. Because this is not despair or anything like that, or not resignation even, but rather more than just acceptance, it's good pleasure and thankfulness and high expectations of reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثم أقبل على حمران وهو عند رأسه, and he turned to Humran, that is the servant of Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan, or his freedman, who was at his bedside. فقال ألا أخبرك لماذا أخشيته والله. Shall I not tell you why I was I'm feeling fearful of what I'm feeling fearful by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أن أمر فيحول بيني وبين الإسلام. That is something that would come and interfere or intervene between me and Islam. So he does not want more fitna or more temptation or trials of this life, and he's happy to be dying as a Muslim and does not want any delay in that. وعن ابن عون عن الحسن قال لما حضرته الوفاة. Now this is Al-Hasan al-Basri. He was at the bedside of Hudhaifa when he died in the previous reports. Now he is dying. On his deathbed, he does what? استرجع. He said, استرجع. He said, إنا لله وإنا إليه راجع. That's استرجع. Like they say, حوقلا is to say, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. علي العظيم. تكبير, we know. تسبيح, we know. تسمية, we know. So all of these have a short form derived from a neologism, a verbal neologism and a nominal neologism. استرجع وأخرج ذراعيه فحركها وقال هذه منزلة صبر واستسلام. And he brought out his arms like that and he shook them like this and he says, this is a station, or this is a context, or this is now a phase, a period of fortitude, steadfastness. This is what sabr is, right? More than patience, steadfastness, and istislam, and complete surrender. Istislam. This word is used by Imam al-Tahawi in his Aqidah Tahawiyya, and when he says Islam is salam and Islam and istislam, and he uses that term, and a complete surrender, turning one over, turning oneself over to Allah's decree. وعن يونس بن عبيد and الحسن البصري ما شاء الله, this remark, I can't help but mention it when he's mentioning his arms. He had huge arms. He was very, very strong, Al-Hasan al-Basri. And said his, in the report that I read, saying his arms were like other people's thighs. That's how big his arms were, mashallah, Hasan al-Basri. طيب. عن يونس بن عبيد قال لما حضرت الحسن الوفاة جعل يسترجع. Again, he was saying إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون, when he was dying, الحسن. فأكب عليه ابنه عبد الله فقال, his son poured over him عبد الله and said, يا أبا father, إنك قد غممتنا, you have made us all sad. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الهم والحزن. هم is also worries, and غم same thing, الغم والهم, right? So they're brothers, linguistic brothers. And you are depressing us. فهل رأيت شيئا, have you seen something? Why you keep saying إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون, have you seen something? قال هي نفسي, it's my nafs, التي لم أصب بمثلها. I have not experienced a reverse of fortune or a hurt or a problem with anything greater than my own life now. Now my life is leaving me. That's why I'm saying, because Allah said that إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. So is there a greater musiba than one's own life, my son is saying. So therefore, it is good that I'm saying that. I do not have to see something special or to be especially worried, but this is worry enough. وعن سهل بن السراج قال لما حضر ابن سيرين الموت جعل يقول. Now, as Hasan al-Basri was to the people of Basra also, Ibn Sirin was to the people of, I think, Medina. Ibn Sirin or Basra, I think he was also Basri. And Ibn Sirin and Al-Hasan al-Basri were the greatest of the Tabi'in to the people of Basra and Iraq. Greatest of Tabi'in to the people of Medina was Ibn al-Musayyib. And the greatest of Tabi'in to the people of Yemen, and we must say in absolute terms, because that's what the Prophet himself called him, was Uwais al-Qarni. So these are the top of the Awliya Allah among the Tabi'in. And he was saying in Sirin, جَعْلَ يَقُلْ إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَجِعُونَ فَيُقَالُ لَهُ قُلْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ فَيَقُلْ إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَجِعُونَ. So they would say to him, say لا إله إلا الله, and he would repeat إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَجِعُونَ. Of course, this is this has a tawheed in it. We belong to Allah, and to Him do we return. And it is more expressive yet of the moment and place and event that they are witnessing, right? And of course, the fiqh of it, Al-Hasan al-Basri was telling his son about it. It's by saying, نفسي التي أصبت فيها. عن الحسن بن دينار أن محمد بن سيرين كان يقول وهو في الموت في سبيل الله نفسي أحب الأنفس علي. In the path of Allah, ابن سيرين was saying on his deathbed, في سبيل الله, my soul, my life is the dearest of all lives to me. So this report, as if explaining the previous one, where he was insisting on istirja, saying inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, even though people were telling him say la ilaha illallah, as because the, you know, they are saying this out of ada, not out of fiqh. He knows that better than them. طيب وعن أبيه قال دخلت على سالم بن أبي الجعد وهو يجود بنفسه. So there, this witness is visiting Salim ibn Abi al-Ja'd, one of the great, also trustworthy narrators of the Tabi'in, as he was breathing with difficulty. فنظر إلي ثم قال لا أفلح من ندم. He looked at me and he said, the one who regrets is not successful. In other words, do not put yourself in a position of regret. Look at that, subhanAllah. So they are breathing with difficulty. When they see someone dear come in, immediately they teach them, prepare yourself. Don't regret. Don't reach this moment and then you regret. يَا لَيْتَنِي قَدَّمْتُ لِحَيَاتِ. عن حبيب بن الشهيد عن ثابت البناني قال, the famous student of Anas ibn Malik in also in Basra, ثابت البناني, and he was a great wali also. He's the one that after they buried him and they arranged the lahad, before there was some flood happened and they had to repair the grave, and one of the stones, the bricks of the lahad had fallen out, and someone peered inside and saw him sitting reciting the Quran. And the person was afraid and ran away, and fixed the grave, and then retold afterwards what he had seen. So he had asked that. He had asked to be able to recite Quran. He loved to recite Quran so much in the grave, and Allah gave him that. Thabit al-Bunani. And his fiqh is also related. He has many stories that are in the biography books. And he is not the one who's dying here. He says, لما حضر جابر بن زيد الوفاة قال أقعدوني فأقعد. When Jabir ibn Zayd was dying, he said, help me up to sit. So he was made to sit. ثم قال أرجعوني. He said, make me lie down again. And they made him lie down. فقال أعوذ بالله من النار وسوء الحساب ثلاث مرات. I seek refuge in Allah from hellfire and a bad accounting. سوء الحساب. He said it three times. So he's asking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he's in turmoil. He's in a state. And خالد بن رخيم قال لما حضرت عطاء ابن أبي رباح حين الوفاة. عطاء بن أبي رباح was a مولى or freedman of the Quraysh. He was a black African slave who had been set free and who took to study Quran and fiqh, and he slept in the mosque for 20 years. He became one of the greatest fuqaha and jurists, the tabi'in. His fiqh is well known and preserved, and he did not found a school, but he has fatwas, and he was also a beautiful reciter of Quran that people love to hear him recite and pray behind him. When he was dying, سَمِعَ بُكَاءً, he heard people crying, or he heard someone crying. فَقَالَ أُدْعُوا لِي إِبْنَ أَبِي حُسَيْنِ لِرَجُلٍ مِنْ قُرَيْشِ. He asked for Ibn Abi Husayn, someone from Quraysh, to come. And the man came, فَقَالَ إِنْهَا هَؤُلَاءَ, go and forbid those people from crying. See, so look, he called someone that he knew would be tough and would make sure that this is carried out. And he went just to tell people not to cry. ثُمَّ قَالَ يَا صَرِيخَ الْأَخْيَارِ, يَا صَرِيخَ الْأَخْيَارِ. Oh, the cry of the chosen ones. Oh, the cry of the chosen ones. Uh, So it could be also Sarikh is the one to whom one cries, right? So it's not just the crying itself that he's longing for. He's longing for the, I mean, the crying out and the expressions of the pious and holy people who would say, mention Allah, not just cry for dunya and make people depressed and unhappy, as if saying to Allah, why? Yani in the Christian tradition, it is almost a requirement to say, why, oh Allah, why? Like that, thinking that it is one of the forms of mourning, proper mourning. And they don't realize that it is a horrible sin. And stabbing themselves, their faith in the heart, by saying that in such a moment. Saying, why? So he is saying, I don't want to hear that. I want to hear the crying out of the pious. Or also he's saying, I want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the Sarikh al-Akhyar, meaning he is the one to whom the Akhyar cry out. Right? And then, عن حزم بن أبي حزم قال سمعت الحسن يقول, I heard Al-Hasan say, إن رجلا من المسلمين حضرته الوفاة فقال له أهله أوصي يا فلان. Al-Hasan al-Basri is relating of someone who was on his deathbed to whom his family was saying, give your last instructions. قال انظروا خاتمة سورة النحل فاستوصوا بها خيرا. Look at the end of Surah An-Nahl and be happy, expect glad tidings from it. فَاسْتَوْصُوا بِهَا خَيْرًا. Take your wasiyah of goodness from there. This is my last instruction to you. And what does it say? إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ مُحْسِنُونَ. Truly Allah is with those who beware, who are aware of him and beware him, and those who do their best, those who do excellence. So you want my last will and testament, this is it. وعن أبي حيان التيمي عن أبيه قال دخلت على الربيع بن خثيم. One of the great awliya also, الربيع بن خثيم, is saying the hadith of the Prophet has a light that comes out of it. You know that this hadith is authentic through that. This is the authentication of awliya is not like the authentication of ordinary scholars. وعنده بكر بن معيز يمرضه. And so بكر بن معيز was treating him. He was in his presence. فأبصر لعابا بلحيته. And this بكر بن معيز, who was tending Al-Rabi' ibn Khuthaym, saw some saliva or something in his beard. Nu'ab, saliva. فَكَزَّ بِوَجْهِهِ. And he grimaced like that with his face. So the caretaker must be very careful, taking care of the even complete strangers, but also more so relatives. But here they say there is no relationship, you see. It's a complete stranger. Must be careful because they notice that. And he grimaced out of disgust, or, you know, taken aback. فَقَالَ لَهُ الرَّبِيعَ أَكَرِهْتَ. Rabia says to him, you hate it? You hate to see that, huh? He says, فَوَاللَّهِ مَا أُحِبُّ أَنَّهُ لِأَعْتَ الدَّيْلَمِ عَلَى اللَّهِ. I swear by Allah, I would not love for it to be among the most rebellious people of Daylam. So Daylam was a Kurdish region that was, Islam had not reached it yet, and was like a figure of speech for the difficulty of making da'wah to them. Those who are most rebellious against Allah of the people of Daylam, still I don't wish for this bit of spittle to be among them, rather than to be on my person. You see, so he loves everything about this state that he's in, even the disgusting parts, Even the undignified part, as they say today, the rebellious ones writing books about the difficulty of death and dying, say there is no dignity in death, blah, boo-hoo, you know, we want to rebel, we want to say that this life is horrible and the dying is horrible and there's nothing redeeming about it. So look at the believer is saying, no, every little bit of every little disgusting bit to me is dear to me, dearer to me than even I would not wish it to be anywhere else, whether among complete strangers who are not even Muslims or rather rebellious, or to be in the wing of a fly in this room. So this is more than acceptance. Again, it's complete embrace. And the people who are right in front of them are unable to understand or access that knowledge that they're in now. SubhanAllah. عن سريتي الربيع قالت لما احتضر الربيع. So this Sariya of the Rabi is the slave woman, right, of Rabi, who was present at the time of his death, and saying that when he was dying, bakat ibnatuhu, his daughter wept. فقال يا بنية لا تبكي ولكن قولي يا بشرى. Oh, darling daughter, don't weep, but say, oh, I'm so happy. Good news, say like that. الْيَوْمَ لَقِيَ أَبِي الْخَيْرِ. Today my father has met with the utmost good. And this is it. This is the proof of Islam. This is basic Islam. And that to be taught like that by the one on his deathbed, it comes in its purest form, in its richest and purest form. And it, short of receiving it from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it comes with complete truthfulness and sincerity, not from the lips of the didactic teacher of preacher. And you can say also al-yawm luqiya abi al-khair, luqiya abi al-khaira. So falaqahum rabbuhum walaqahum madratan wa surura. Yani Allah cast upon them and put upon them darkness and happiness. So that would be a Quranic. That is probably what that's the manuscript has Luqiya. I don't know why he corrected it to Laqiya, to an active form instead of Luqiya, the passive form, which means that the agent is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the doer of that imparting to, because probably the editor thought that no, that would be presumption to say he's already in paradise. But he's saying that. No, it's not presumption. And if it is, let it be his responsibility, the speaker. Do not take it on yourself to correct his own words. So as conveyed by the manuscripts, you'd see the remark in the footnote. So, لُقِّيَ أَبِي الْخَيْرَ. عَلَى عَبْدِ الْمَلِكِ بْنِ عُمَيْرِ قَالَ قِيلَ لِلْرَّبِيعِ بْنِ قُثَيْمِ أَلَا نَدْوُ لَكَ طَبِيبًا قَالَ انْظُرُوا. Oh, the same one also, shall we not call a physician for you? He said, look for one. ثم تفكر فقال. Then he thought and he said, وعادا وثمود وأصحاب الرس وقرونا بين ذلك كثيرا. And he's thinking of all of the previous civilizations that disappeared. فذكر من حرصهم على الدنيا ورغبتهم فيها. And then he discussed how much they were keen on living and living strong and good, building up themselves and loving, being in love with this world. كانت فيهم مرضى وكانت فيهم أطباء. They also had sick people among them and they had physicians, he says. فما أرى المداوي بقي ولا المتداوى. And I do not see any of them remaining, neither the healer nor the one that is expecting healing. هلك الناعت والمنعوت له. So the one who is describing and the one that is prescribing and the one that is prescribed for, they all died. And he's saying, do as you like, but I'm leaving. Again, many of them spoke like that, and Abu Bakr also said the same thing. The healer is the one who put me in that state. عن أبي معشر قال دخلنا على إبراهيم النخعي حين ثقل فجعل يقول لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. إبراهيم النخعي, one of the great jurists of Kufa in Iraq, and the archteacher of those that later on it became the Hanafi Mazhab. Ibrahim Nakhai is a great reference for them, and he has also, his fiqh is preserved and it's quite voluminous, and he was a great scholar of hadith as well. And when he was dying, he was saying that قَالَ فَلَمَّا زَادَ ثَقْلًا جَعَلَ يَنْقُصُ حَتَّى قَالَ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ ثُمَّ قَضَى. So he would say the whole phrase that I read, then as he was getting worse and worse, he was saying less and less, saying la ilaha illallah wahda, and then la ilaha illallah, and then he passed. Inshallah. And Imran al-Khayyat قال دخلت على إبراهيم أعود وهو يبكي. I went in to see the same Ibrahim as he was dying, and he was crying. فقلت ما يبكيك يا أبا عمران قال أنتظر ملك الموت لا أدري بالجنة يبشرني أم بالنار. Says I'm waiting for the angel of death and I'm not sure, is he going to give me the glad tidings of paradise or of hellfire. He's crying because of that. This is the state that the Prophet ﷺ described the believer is between those two states, hope and fear. Now, and it is like they said that even if I had one foot inside paradise, I would still not be sure until both feet are inside. عن زكريا بن يحيى الكندي قال دخلت على الشعبي وهو يشتكي فقلت له كيف تجدك. الشعبي another great of the tabi'in, imam and scholar of hadith, faqih. And he's saying, how are you feeling? He's on his deathbed. The visitor is asking, how are you feeling? قال أجدني وجعا مجهودا. I find myself ailing and in extreme stress and difficulty. مجهودا. Same root as ijtihad and jihad. So great effort and struggle, struggling. I find myself ailing and struggling greatly. اللهم إني أحتسب نفسي عندك فإنها أعز الأنفس علي. Allah, entrust my soul with you, for it is the dearest of all souls to me. عن الحسن وغيره قال عاد نفر من الصدر الأول رجلا فوجدوه في الموت. الحسن البصري tells of a story of visitors of a person who was dying. فقال له بعض القوم, some of them said, ما عندك في مصرعك هذا. What are you feeling in this final state of yours? Masra is destruction. There is a book called Masari' al-Ushaq, the dying of those who died out of passionate love, the death of those who died. So Masari' is death and destruction. قال الرضا والتسليم لأمر الله. I find in this destruction of mine, I find good pleasure and surrender to the command of Allah. He is beyond denial, he is beyond anger, he is now in complete surrender. قال فما برح القوم حتى قضى. And not long after that, they had not even left, he passed away. قال الحسن. الحسن now comments on his reply. عرف والله أن موئلهما إلى خير. Said he was absolutely certain, I swear it. عرف, يعني he knew for sure that the final end of these two states of complete acceptance and complete surrender is a good end. Is a good destination, a He was sure of that. That's why he was unfazed. And he answered to their dunya question, he answered the akhirah answer, but with a straight face. I mean, this is exactly what he was completely in that moment and in that state. And Al-Hasan, alhamdulillah, commented in a constructive way for our benefit on it. وعن صالح بن عبد الكريم قال حدثنا شيخ كان يغزو البحر قال this sheikh who was sailing and fighting at sea said كان بالبصرة رجل من العباد يقال له عزوان. There was a worshipful wali in Basra called عزوان فحضرته الوفاة فقيل له ما تشتهي. Death came to him and they said to him, what do you crave right now? He replied, قال عجلة الموت, a quick death. قيل فإن كانت العافية, what if health comes to you again back? قال فطول هذا الليل والنهار. Then another long night and day, another long day and night. And he doesn't expect more, he doesn't want more. I don't know, so it's their heart is already where their gaze and their thoughts are in the next life. So we read this last report, inshallah, for the day, we'll call it a day. عن محمد بن مطرف قال دخلنا على أبي حازم الأعرج لما حضره الموت. This Salama ibn Dinar al-Madini, Abu Hazim al-A'raj, is dying, and they went in to see him. فقلنا يا أبا حازم كيف تجدك؟ Abu Hazim, how do you feel? قال أجدني بخير. I feel good. I find myself feeling good. قال أجدني راجيا لله حسن الظن به. I feel I'm hopeful for Allah. I have good thoughts about Allah. ثم قال إنه والله ما يستوي من غدا وراح يعمل عقد الآخرة لنفسه. He said, I swear that they are not the same. On the one hand, the one who goes early and comes back late, building up the real estate of Akhirah. عقد, plural of uqda, in the sense of the land, the real estate that you have, a garden full of orchards and good things. And he's referring to the hereafter, and it's being built up. نفسي فيقدمها أمامه قبل أن ينزل به الموت. And he is preparing that ahead of himself before death comes to him. حتى يقدم عليها فيقوم لها وتقوم له. Until death comes to him, and then he rises up for that real estate, and it also comes to life for him at that time. So for this is very palpable. The people of belief is occupied, preoccupied by that, same way as people of unbelief are preoccupied by their bank account and their insurance and their retirement benefits and so forth. ومن غدا وراح في عقد الدنيا أو عقد الدنيا يعمرها لغيره. And on the other hand, the one that is building up the real estate of this world for someone else than him, because he would never be able to, and after death, to enjoy. ويرجع إلى الآخرة لا حظ له فيها ولا نصيب. And he returns back to the hereafter, but without any portion there, and with nothing as his lot. He has nothing as his lot in the hereafter, and we seek refuge in Allah from that. اللهم أدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار وتجاوز عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا. يا ربي صل على سيدنا محمد واختم بالحسنات أعمالنا. صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. إن شاء الله we'll see you next week same time بإذن الله تعالى. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم.